Cape Cod's natural beauty is what makes it so unique. What makes it beautiful also makes it vulnerable, especially to sea, wind, and storm.
Slowly but steadily, sea level rise is threatening the Cape. As sea level rises, already nearly a foot in my lifetime, our coast changes. Cape Cod has changed. The impacts are happening now, above and below the ground, some visible, some invisible. Some of the invisible changes happening in response to sea level rise are changes in our fresh water, our aquifer, our streams, our wetlands, and our water table all change in direct response to sea level. The Association to Preserve Cape Cod is working to understand these changes and better plan for changes that we will all face. We need to adapt so that our ecosystem, energy, wastewater, and communication systems function and our natural beauty is preserved.
We moved down in 1967. New Silver Beach initially consisted of 10,000 square foot lots, lots of little postage stamp lots. If this was a natural situation, we would have a barrier beach out here and a marsh and lagoon behind it. But that's all gone. That's been filled in, that's been changed, so you can't see it. I knew the history of the hurricanes in Buzzards Bay, so I should have probably not bought the property. But we did anyways. And I wanted to be near the water because I love boats and sailing. I had two boys. And I want them to be good sailors, and so it was important to bring them up here.
Water systems are connected. In other words, groundwater of Cape Cod is very much connected to its surface water, through the ponds and streams. And the groundwater and the surface water are both connected to the ocean. And what happens with the ocean ends up affecting what happens inland. Cape Cod is a sole source aquifer. It's been designated as such by the Environmental Protection Agency. It is literally the sole source of drinking water for the residents of Cape Cod. The USGS, in cooperation with the Association to Preserve Cape Cod and the Cape Cod Commission, is doing a study to map areas that are, if you will, close to the water table, less than 10 feet to water, under current conditions and under conditions associated with future potential rise in sea level, 2 feet, 4 feet, and 6 feet higher sea level than today. In some sense, the project could be called an inundation from below study.
This is one of our more complex wells. There's four wells in it, and they're all at different depths.
The objective is to characterize this whole aquifer from top to bottom, to see what resources, both drinking water, freshwater wetland resources, will be impacted.
When sea level rise occurs, there is a sort of a cascade of effects. That freshwater lens that floats on the saline groundwater at depth rises accordingly. The rate at which the groundwater levels are rising in some of our observation wells closely match the rate of sea level rise that's been observed at long-term tide gauge stations at Woods Hole and in Boston.
10.76.
That's a big issue for Cape Cod because we have a very high concentration of septic systems.
It is good to think about what the implications of sea level rise are to wastewater treatment, particularly in the low-lying areas, because the treatment isn't there. And then we're going to start really impacting our particular surface water, recreational shellfish waters, and things like that.
The highest concentration of population tends to be right along the coast as well, where, of course, the depth of water table is the most shallow. One could expect that Falmouth, Mashpee, up into Hyannis, you know, the areas that are lowest lying along the coastal ponds, for example, could be the areas that experience the biggest effect from sea level rise. Those areas are going to see high water tables that will potentially interfere with subsurface infrastructure, particularly septic systems.
For the town sewered the area, I put in three different septic systems over less than 40 years. There were houses on Silver Beach Avenue in the low spots, which are still using cesspools, which overflowed, and not only that, but they were flooded out every time the water was above normal and polluted the whole area.
Well, in Hurricane Bob, we came down to the area because, you know, it was flooded completely in particularly the area that's sewered right now. And all I remember is people not being able to get to their homes and walking a little bit toward the edge of where the water had come up to, and you could see some cesspool covers right there. So it was like those systems were completely flooded. In other situations where the flooding may not be extensive, you could have wastewater right beneath the surface and not see it. And then, of course, when you start using that system, it sort of pulses out to the ground surface. And that's where it really represents a public health threat.
There are a lot of concerns about future scenarios where, with climate change, groundwater levels might be rising. We're interested in understanding how endocrine disruptors, hormone-mimicking chemicals, and other contaminants of emerging concern can make their way from septic systems through groundwater and ultimately end up in drinking water and in ponds. For instance, we've found pharmaceuticals, such as antibiotics, in drinking water, and this raises potential concerns about antibiotic resistance. We've also found chemicals called perfluorinated chemicals. These are found in non-stick and stain-resistant products, as well as having commercial applications. And these have been linked to a number of health effects as well, including cancer, hormone disruption, and liver damage. We think that septic systems are a source of emerging contaminants into Cape Cod groundwater.
The wonderful ponds, streams, wetlands, and the underlying groundwater system are all connected to the ocean. And it's not a one-way connection in that it's not just fresh water that flows into the ocean, but the rise in the level of the ocean will be affecting the freshwater systems as well.
We were pretty happy with these results. This is pretty different from difficult.
It's not like the changes are going to happen in the next week or month. It's a long-term change, no question. But decisions that are made about development and about infrastructure and utilities, et cetera, are done over the long term. It'll be possible to say, well, X percent, for example, of the area of a town can be expected to be less than 10 feet to the water table given a certain sea level rise projection. And that can be of use in order to prioritize resources for protecting as open space, for example, areas that are not presently developed on the coastline. It can be of value to think about alternatives for wastewater where septic systems are no longer going to be viable.
sewer line should definitely be located in areas that are not going to be subject to the groundwater rise, because sewer lines are subject to infiltration and exfiltration. That's the water coming into them from the groundwater, which then stresses the treatment plant, and water, of course, the wastewater exiting them, because that could be near a sensitive resource, and that's sewerage coming out of those lines.
Our past work has shown that public and private wells that are located in more densely developed areas tend to have higher levels of emerging contaminants, coming primarily from septic systems. Efforts to conserve and keep open land near public and private water supplies will result in better water quality.
We need to take realistic approaches in terms of coastal erosion, coastal flooding, and find the best solution to those problems, because they're not going to go away. They're just going to continue and perhaps get worse. You just have to figure out how to live with it.
As you have seen, there is more to sea level rise than coastal flooding and erosion. Luckily, there is time to plan and prepare.
We can minimize human influences on sea level by reducing our carbon footprint, conserving energy, and switching to renewable sources like solar, wind, and tide. We need to seriously reevaluate our approach to coastal development and protection. Modeling sea level rise will help us understand the areas that will be most impacted and impacted the soonest.
We are all vulnerable, and acting together, we can preserve Cape Cod's beauty for generations to come.